Welcome to Bonehead Gaming.
Okay, fellow gamers, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die multiplayer map. This is just a quick update, really, on the castle build and a little bit of the base. Now, you see I've got a bear and a zombie there, so I'm going to take care of those in a minute. Coming into my base, if you watched the earlier videos, you'll know I've got a big old drop there, so be wary of that. Now, this base hasn't really been defended against anything yet, so we're going to start with a bear. Yeah, we get his attention. Right, so bear is now coming down towards us. I'm stuck. There we go. Bear's stuck on the spike, so he ain't coming through. Come on. Yeah, see, I can club him through there. That's all good. Okay, so that is the bear taken care of. So, as you can see, the defences ain't too bad. I can kill him from there, I can shoot through, I can use melee, and I can harvest. He can't get through, all thanks to these poles here. Let's get rid of that. Right, let's reload the submachine gun. So, any of you guys that have watched my video before may notice a slight difference out here. Each of these corners, I had a spotlight facing out diagonal corners, so you can see zombies at night time. I had trees down here. Oops, sorry about little lag spikes then. And the whole of this clear bit was trees as well. Reason I've cleared all that is because I was getting major lag. My little farm all here. If I drop down, the only way into my base is this main door here. Like I say, this trap door, got a duck to get out, is about 20-25 blocks. When you get to the bottom, there's a couple fully upgraded big spikes like these. So if you survive the drop, hopefully you won't be alive for long. And I've got concrete down there as well, so if you try smashing your way out, it will take a while. Now I'm going to run through this base quickly because I haven't changed much. This was my initial starting area. I've removed all of this now, so these boxes are all empty. Anything that's left is just useless junk that's not needed. My sleeping area, you know, just the basic sleeping bag. As we come down here, this here was my mine. So you see I've got a tunnel down there, pretty much gathered most of my resources from this mine. It's been a pretty good one actually. Back up here, turn the light off. Coming down the tunnel into my second base. Now lighting is actually very bright here. You can see I've not got any flashlight on. That's flashlight on, flashlight off. Every fifth block, these ones here that are upgraded, I have torches underneath the floor and above the ceiling, which is why it's so bright. Now, one little bit I don't think I put in my video before. I've got this room here, which is going to turn into the bedroom. I've not got around to doing that. With projects, I don't really stick to them for too long. I get bored and move on. So, just here. Get the map up. That there is a the food store. I forget what they call it now. So, basically, I can go down the tunnel, climb up here, and I'm in the back of the food store. Get my light on. I've sealed up the doors, only basic wood. I've not really done the windows too much, and it's all ready for looting. It's been a while since I've been here. So I can still see out, I can defend a little bit if need be. To be honest, this won't be used too much. Yeah, some moldy sandwiches. Alright, let's get down. I need to sort this dirt out because getting in and out can get a little tricky sometimes. Further on down, get onto the boik. Alright, stop this here. Now, just over here, I've got myself a water source and another entrance into the base. The second house here, so my base is down here, the tunnel comes all the way up, is a swimming pool. I've basically dug a hole down, so it goes down and then about a slope, about 15 blocks slope I think it is, down to this side. I was hoping the water would trickle more than that, but sadly it seems to be quite crap basically. Alright, so one more thing to show you, which was in the last video, but I'll go over it quickly, just for those that didn't see. I will link the old video into the description as well for anyone who is interested. A bit more information, a bit more detail. Ooh, come on. Learn to drive, Jay. Oh, forgot my flashlight. So here is my crafting storage kitchen area. So got my fires there, or furnaces, furnaces, campfires, furnaces all along there, and all my storage and supplies. My crafting facilities over here, and some cupboards. So basically ventilation shafts, you know, give it a bit more pleasing aesthetics. Just instead of a boring old dot this here, drop that there. Now over here is my spike pit. No zombies here. I did actually record this video already, but sadly right at the end of it my recording software glitched out. So you did actually get to see a couple zombies fall in there and die. Sadly that won't happen today. Okay, that's my exit. So I have flashlight, barbed wire, and iron bars all around. So hurts them, kills them, and stops them climbing in. If they do get on the top, because there is a ramp at the back. So you can literally just walk up the top. They can smash through this side, but it's going to take a while longer. They will drop down, and they will not be able to drop in, hopefully. This is the entrance. So if you don't make the jump, you fall down there. If you make the jump, you go there. Now, those again of you watching the last video, you'll notice I've dug this little ditch. If I park the bike here and go full throttle, I can make that jump. Otherwise, I don't touch the floor till I hit the bottom of the base, and that hurts. Okay guys, we're back, and you can now see the start of the castle. Now I'll do a quick lap around the outside first, just give you an idea. So I had the double layer of spikes all along the base here. They can be repaired, replaced, and fitted from the inside. I have the walkway all along the top here, so you can defend from the outside. I have the wall that goes all the way around, and the three layer, or, yeah, well, tower's got four floors if you count the ground floor. There are four ways into the base. We have entrance on foot. Go down there and there's a tunnel going all the way across. So all the way across here, and it comes out just one there and one there. Get a little bit more in. This building here also has an entrance in. So you go down the side, you come in, you can come out there. Or I have there and here for the bikes, which are the entrances we're going to use. So jump on the old bike. Now these entrances I actually found watching Games for Kicks. Pretty good 7 Days to Die player. I've only started watching him recently, but I have been very much enjoying his videos. Learning a fair few things. And with these pillars, you can just fall straight through them. But you can't climb through them. You can almost get stuck in them, but you can't climb through them. Okay, so we are inside the base. We have four towers. We also have... Shush. Okay, bike doesn't want to be quiet. Never mind. We have the nice little entrance here. Comes up onto a bit of hay, all the way across. And a nice entrance over there. Or entrance exit. This side here, you may notice I got a little bridge. I will do that on the side behind me as well. Just getting time to do it. And these little ramps, I've got one this side, one that side. Originally, I wasn't sure how to get an entrance in and out of my base with a bike. So I had the ramps to get out, and I was going to do exactly the same on the other side with a small gap so zombies couldn't walk across. But didn't really like the idea, and then I saw this idea on Games for Kicks, and stole it. I will link his channel in the video, so if you guys want to check him out, that'd be awesome. Okay, so let's turn the flashlight. Every tower, start from downstairs. I have a spotlight pointing out at a diagonal. Now, down the bottom towers, nothing really special. You can repair any of the spikes from any point. You can get a full 360 view. You may have to move around a little bit, but you can see everything. And again, I've used these poles to stop anything climbing in. So, if you want to go up a little bit higher, we got floor number 2. Now, this one has the iron bars all the way around. You won't fall through these gaps, so don't worry about that. So you can look over all the spikes here, you can cover any spot you want. Any zombies around, you can just crouch down, have a look out. If you are playing PvP, which this is what the server was originally intended, which is one reason why I built the castle, you've got the little wall I don't know what you call these little turrets or trussels, I don't know. But you can hide behind those, you know, a bit of cover fire, shoot, down, reload, get up, shoot, reload, you know, all that cover. So let's go across to the next tower. All four towers are pretty much identical. The only difference really in them is that tower there. It's a block shorter than everything else. I'll show you when I get there. Small little changes between each one as well. I mean, that chest is just a dump chest. It's empty at the moment. Each tower does have, on this third floor, a chest. And I have 25 pipe bombs on each. I have a crossbow with 250 bolts. Each one has a different weapon. This one's pistol. Each one has 5 first aids, a few bandages, and a bit of wood repair. We'll house some cement and iron as well. Once I finally get the resources to do it, I haven't even finished the actual castle yet. And then you can go onto the top floor, a bit of metal trussing, and another iron bar around. So you can again come across. You've got the double layer of protection for two iron bars. Any spitters and stuff like that should miss you. At least that's the theory. I mean, if you're on this floor here, again, there's no iron bars on this floor, so you're just shooting out the window, so be careful. I have left these bits open. Hopefully, the hornets can't get through, but you can still shoot through. I have this big ass open space here, and this is the one reason, or main reason, I'm making this video now. Because I would like you guys to leave in the comments any ideas of what I can do with this area. I mean, this was a house that I knocked down. That square there is the entrance into the tunnel, which comes out over there, or over there, or that house there. But, I mean, this will be my main base after this point. I will be moving a base here. I think I'm going to keep it above ground as well, rather than underground. So any sort of ideas you guys can give me. The next chest again. This one's got the hunter rifle, but all the supplies are the same. And again, we've got the turret walls all the way around. So yeah, any ideas you guys could give me for what I could do inside would be brilliant. I mean, this base was originally meant for one person. I think I made it big enough for four, if not eight, to defend. When I get to this turret here, you can see it's got one drop down. The reason for that is I made the floor one lower than the rest. Doesn't really affect it too much, apart from you've got to jump up here. And again, when you get around to this side, you've got to jump up there. That's really the only difference. A little bit lower in height. Again, a chest. This one's got the magnum, still got crossbows and all the rest of the supplies. So, thank you very much, guys. Please do leave a comment suggesting what I can do with this area, because that's one thing I've really got to figure out now, what to do with that. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. Bye.